Daughters, granddaughters, nieces, girlfriends. We were sitting at lunch one day when my daughter casually said that she and her husband were thinking of raising a family. "We're taking a survey," she said. "Do you think I should have a baby?" "It'll change your life," I said, in a carefully neutral tone. "I know," she said. "No more lying in on weekends, no more spontaneous vacations." But that's not what I meant at all. I look at my daughter, trying to decide what to tell her. I want her to know what she will never learn in childbirth classes. I want to tell her that the physical wounds of childbearing will heal, but becoming a mother will leave her with an emotional wound so raw that she will forever be vulnerable. I consider warning her that she will never again read a newspaper without asking, "What if that had been my child?" That every plane crash, every house fire will haunt her. That when she sees pictures of starving children, she will wonder if anything will be worse than watching your child die. I feel that I should warn her that no matter how many years she has invested in her career, she will be professionally derailed by motherhood. She might arrange for childcare, but one day she will be going in for an important business meeting and she will think of her baby's sweet smile. She will have to use every ounce of discipline to keep from running home just to make sure her baby is all right. However decisive she may be at the office, she will second guess herself constantly as a mother. Looking at my attractive daughter, I want to assure her that eventually she'll lose the pounds of pregnancy, but she will never feel the same about herself. That her life, now so important, will be of lesser value to her once she has a child. That she will give it up in a moment to save her offspring. But she will also begin to wish for longer years. Not to accomplish her own dreams, but to watch her child accomplish hers or his. I want her to know that a cesarean scar or shiny stretch marks will become badges of honor. I wish my daughter could sense that bond she will feel with women throughout history who have tried to stop war, prejudice, and drunk driving. I hope she will understand why I can think rationally about almost any issue, but become temporarily insane when I discuss the threat of nuclear war to my child's future. I want to describe to my daughter the exhilaration of seeing your child learn to ride a bike. I want to capture for her the belly laugh of a baby who's touching the soft fur of a dog or cat for the first time. I want her to taste the joy that is so real that it actually hurts. Looking at my daughter with her quizzical look, I realize that my eyes are filled with tears. "You'll never regret it," I say. I reach across the table, squeeze her hand, and offer a silent prayer for her, for me, and all the mere mortal women who stumble into that most wonderful of all callings, this blessed gift from God, that of being a mother. We're going to be doing this fun poem for you. Probably some of you know it already. It has four lines of a refrain, and it would be great if you could join us in the last two lines.
we'll say, I'm a woman phenomenally, and then you say, phenomenal woman, that's me. Can we try that once? Okay? I'll say, I'm a woman phenomenally.
You say,
phenomenal woman? Phenomenal woman, that's me.
Come on, louder, let's do it one more time, okay?
I'm a woman phenomenally.
Phenomenal woman, that's me.
Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. But when I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman phenomenally.
Phenomenal woman, that's me.
I walk into a room just cool as you please. And to the man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they hover around me, a hive of honeybees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes, the flash of my teeth, the swing of my waist, the joy in my feet. Because I am a woman phenomenally.
Phenomenal woman, that's me.
Men have always wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. When I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say, it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breasts, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally.
Phenomenal woman, that's me.
Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't have to shout, or jump about, or talk real loud. When you see me pass, it ought to make you proud.
I say, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palm of my hand, and the need of my care.
'Cause I'm a woman, phenomenally.
Phenomenal woman, that's me.
Doing it when they reach puberty or whatever the hell it is.
If you're not married by 25, if you don't have two kids by 27 or 28, downhill.
Yeah. But I don't know whether there is something to be said for slightly early. I don't. Of course, we're all living longer, but childbearing, probably it's easier to deal with children when you're younger.
When you're younger, yes.
And rather than older parents. Realists. Colorful.